Hello friends, welcome back to another tutorial on microservices, and in this video we are going to cover the 12 principles or factors of microservices. Remembering these principles directly, it's not that easy, and that's why it's a kind of difficult question normally asked by interviews, but I always try to remember the things as a sentence, and for that one I also made one sentence. So if you remember this sentence, you will definitely able to answer those interview questions and definitely remember each and every principle. So in this case, the sentence written in red, yes, this one is the sentence made by me, that is, please dad love cute boy and please dad care cute beautiful daughter. And for P, it's port binding, means the every microservice should have a dedicated port and should be binded with it. This is the number one principle. Second, disposability. Disposability means that you can start and stop any microservice without impacting your other services and the environment or the infrastructure. There should not be any impact or least impact on other services. Logs. Normally, if you're running 12 to 15 or 50 web services, not microservices, then there might be a chance that their logs might be spread all around the infrastructures and the VMs and the Linux machine, Windows machines. So rather than one principle says that it should be a common log repository like Splunk or any other tool which you like. So all the microservices should talk to that stream, Splunk stream, or any other tool that you're aware of. Codebase. Each and every microservice should have its own codebase. It should not be that you are keeping the codebase of two microservices in one code repository, so that you can build, deploy, and run quickly without impacting any other service. Backing services. Backing services means where microservice definitely depends on some backing service like DB, messaging services. So it should be very easy that we can replace our DB or these backing services with anybody without impacting anything. It should be plug and play kind of things. Admin processes. Yes, you are a developer, so you might be doing so many admin processes without keeping it track, like conversion, migration, some kind of thing. But our microservice suggests that you should keep these processes as scripts, which should be checked in somewhere, and always run the scripts, not directly going into DB or to validation and do it something manually. Don't do it. Follow this principle. Next is processes. Your microservice should always be stateless. They can be killed and replaced at any timeout without the fear of loss of service instance, which may result in data loss. So there should not be any fear that if the service is losing something, then it's losing some data. Dev prod parity. What it means that we need to minimize the gap between environments. The dev environment or your local development environment on developer system should be look like exactly same as prod, so that there should be minimum difficulty when you're releasing something on production. The gap should not be of weeks, it should be of couple of hours. So mimic your production environment into dev or the local development coding environment, whatever you say. Next is concurrency. Concurrency. The Microsoft principle says that whenever you want to scale up, don't use threading. Try to scale the service Like if you are familiar with AWS auto-scaling, so scale your web service rather than making it multi-threaded. So you can scale up, scale down at any moment. So it should be there. Config means that all configuration of your microservices should be kept in some separate repository apart from your code. And while the runtime should be fetched from somewhere else and deployed it. So keep your config separate from the code. Build, release, run. So this principle says that these three cycles should be independent. You build it, you release it, you run it. And if you found something wrong, then go back to build, release, and then run. Don't do it like we can remove something on runtime, cherry pick, or some kind of things. Don't do it. Next is dependencies. Dependencies says that whatever jars or third-party libraries you are using, it should be mentioned in POM if you're using Maven or build, Gradle, whatever you're using, it should be mentioned there. You should not use without mentioning it. Hope everything is clear, because these are normal things, but sometimes it looks like 12 principles of microservices. How can I remember? Port binding is very simple, disposability is very simple, logs, code base, backing services, admin processes, depth or parity, concurrency. These are simple things. It's in your normal life. Whenever you design a microservice, you should keep that. It should be like this. And remember this sentence. Please, Dad, love, cute boy or baby. And please, Dad, care, cute, beautiful daughter. That's it. So I am stopping this video at this point. Please subscribe my channel. I will posting videos related to different concepts of microservices, the all two libraries which are used to managing all these microservices in my upcoming videos. So keep watching. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.